Animated gradient background is an amazing motion graphics that will help you to create colorful looking and creatively animated background for your videos. It is a quick and easy way to enhance the look and feel of your motion graphics. So in today's video, we will take a look at how to create an amazing animated gradient background inside of DaVinci Resolve in a few simple steps. Hey guys, this is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's open DaVinci Resolve and get started. Alright guys, so this is DaVinci Resolve 18 edit page, and before we get started we have to do some basic setting as usual. So click on this setting button in the corner and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080. Simply click on the drop down menu and select any resolution from here. You can use 4K resolution as well. Now we have to select a frame rate. So in this case I'm using 24 frames per second. You can select any frame rate according to you and click on save. And then we have to create this background inside of this fusion page. So take a new fusion composition first. So just go to this media pool. If you don't have this media pool window, then you can click on the media pool, right click on the media pool and click on new fusion composition. And this is going to be the background. So let's call it BZ, which is the short form of background. Duration, make it 5 seconds long for this one and click on create. Let's drag and drop this background on this timeline and then go to the fusion page. And here we have the media out node, so just drag this media out to the side for now. Let's start by creating a background. So this is the background button. Let's drag and drop on this flow window, drag it to the viewer. So this is the black background, so we have to change the color. So just go to the inspector window and here we have the color. Let's select a purple color. You can select any color combination according to you and hit OK. After that we have to attach a rectangle mask with this. So this is the rectangle. Let's drag and drop on this flow window, attach the rectangle with the background, select the rectangle and do some setting over here. So here we have the width value. Let's set the width value 0.28, height value 0.5 and corner radius 0.4. you can set this value according to you. And this is the angle, so we have to animate the angle by using an expression. So it's very simple. Right click on the angle, click on the expression, and I'm gonna use a time expression to animate this angle. So let's type time multiply by 1, and then we have to animate the center. So right click on center, go to modify width and select this modifier sig, and then just go to the modifier page and here we have to do some setting. So this is a random set. Let's set the value maybe 5000, and this is the smoothness. Let's set the value 25, and here we have the minimum and maximum. So set the minimum value 0.5, maximum 0.1, and finally we will get a random animation just like this. After that we have to create a copy of these two nodes. So select both the nodes, hit Ctrl C to copy, or you can also right click on these node and click on copy, right click over here and paste the node. Now drag and drop the second background to the viewer, select the background node and change the color. So in this case I'm using this color, hit OK. Select the second rectangle and let's change some value, and here we have the angle. So let's change this time expression value. I'm gonna set the value time multiply by -1, and then go to the modifier, change the random seed, set the value maybe 20,000, and we have to change the minimum and maximum value. So I'm gonna set the minimum value 0, maximum value 1. And now we have to create one more copy. So hit Ctrl V on the keyboard to paste. Drag this third background to the viewer, select the background and change the color maybe like this. Select the third rectangle, and again we have to change some settings. So just go to the modifier and here I'm gonna set the random seed value 10,000. We have the minimum and maximum, so set the minimum value 1 and maximum value maybe 0.5. perfect. And now we have 3 different copies, so we have to rename it properly. It's very simple. You can simply select the node, hit F2 on the keyboard to rename, or you can also right click on these node and click on rename. So I'm gonna quickly rename these node. Perfect. And now we have to merge all the node together. So it's very simple. Either you can take a new merge node and connect the yellow background point with this first one and green foreground point with the second one, or you can also simply connect the output of this foreground with the background and we will get the new merge. Let's drag the merge to the viewer and finally we will get something like this. Now we have to attach the directional blur effect. So select the final output, hit Ctrl plus a spacebar for search box and search for directional blur. So this is the directional blur node, hit add button, drag it to the viewer. Select the directional blur and do the setting as usual. So just go to the inspector window and here we have the type. Let's change the type to radial. Let's increase the length of the blur. So I'm gonna set the value 0.4 and you can change the angle as well. So I'm gonna set the angle maybe negative 150 degree. And finally, we have to add one more effect, which is the glow. So again, select the last node, hit Ctrl plus a spacebar, search for glow. Add the glow effect, drag it to the viewer. Select the glow and let's down the value. So I'm gonna set the glow value 0.3, which is looking perfect. And now we have to attach the main output with a background. So let's create a background first. So this is the background button. Let's drag and drop on the flow window, drag it to the viewer. Let's create a blue background. So I'm gonna set the value of blue color, maybe 0.2. And we will get this type of blue background. Now we have to merge this main output with the background. So it's very simple. Connect the output of this glow with the background and we will get the new merge. Let's drag and drop to the viewer. And finally, we have nice and simple gradient background. Now you can connect the media out with the main output, then go to the edit page. And here we have nice and simple gradient background, which is looking very awesome. And now let me show you one more thing. You can simply increase the duration of the background by dragging like this and it will work perfectly. So you can use this background for any text or logo. So let me quickly add a text on this background. So just go to the fusion page, right click on that, click on new fusion composition. This is going to be the text. So let's call it text, hit OK. And this is the text. Let's drag and drop on the timeline and let's set it like this. Then go to the fusion page and add a text very quickly. So this is the text node. Let's attach the text with the media out. Select the text and type anything, whatever you want. Select your favorite font style. Increase the size of the text a little bit. Let's increase the tracking amount a bit. And change this to a thin font, maybe like this. And then go to the edit page. And here it's looking very awesome as you can see. And now let's have a look. So turn on the loop button, go to full screen by hitting Ctrl F and let's have a look.
Alright, so that is it for now. I hope you like this video. If you have any question, drop a message on my Instagram and comment down below. And if you are watching this video first time on this channel, please hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos and also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikash and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.